Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends. In this video, we will study the differences between the synchronous and asynchronous data transmission methods. So let us start with our topic. Whenever we talk about the communication between two components, we say that one component is sending the data to another component, or we can say that data transmission is taking place between the two components. Means exchange of data is taking place. Data transmission is taking place between the two components. This data transmission, it can be of two types: serial data transmission and parallel data transmission. Now, when this type of transmission is taking place, like serial and parallel data transmission, when the sender is sending the data to the receiver, so there is a need for synchronization between the sender and receiver, that when the data is starting, from where the data is starting, at what position the data is ending, and what's the capacity, what's the speed of that data transmission. For all this, we need the synchronization. So based on the synchronization, the data transmission is of two types: synchronous and asynchronous data transmission. So here we will study the differences between these two types, synchronous and asynchronous data transmission. That what's the differences between the two methods. So let us start with it. The first and the most important difference between the two methods is that in the synchronous data transmission, a clock pulse is used, and two signals are used. One is the clock pulse and second is the data signal. So this clock pulse is going to indicate the receiver that from where the data is starting and at what position the data is ending. So here in the synchronous method, a clock pulse is used and a data signal is used, whereas in the case of asynchronous, only one signal is used, that is the data signal. So first difference, we can say that first basic difference is that in synchronous, two signals are used, whereas in asynchronous, only one signal is used. Now, as we are talking about the synchronization between the sender and the receiver, so in the case of synchronous mode, the sender and receiver, they will be having clocks. Single clock is there, and that clock is common between the sender and receiver. Whereas in asynchronous, no clock signal is required. The internal clock of the sender and the receiver will be used. So we can say that the second difference is that sender and receiver, should have synchronized clocks before data transmission. So here an external clock is required. And in the case of asynchronous, the sender and receiver, they do not require any clock, no synchronization is required. So we can say that it's the second difference. In asynchronous, does not require So in the asynchronous, no clock is required, but in this case, a parity bit is added to the data before the transmission. Suppose we are transmitting an 8-bit data, so to that 8-bit data, a parity bit is added. The parity bits mean start and the stop bits are added. Start bit will indicate that from this position the data is starting, and stop bits will indicate the ending of the data. So the difference between synchronous and asynchronous is that the starting and the ending of the data is indicated by the clock pulse in the case of synchronous, and in the case of asynchronous it is indicated by the start and the stop bits. Okay, so here a clock is required and that clock should be synchronized, whereas in the case of asynchronous no clock is required, whereas we are adding a parity bit. So we can say that in synchronous the third difference is that an external clock is required. We can say external clock is used. Okay, whereas in asynchronous the sender and the receiver, they are going to use their internal clocks. Also, another difference is that in the case of synchronous, as we are using the external clock, so for transmitter and the receiver there is a common clock. Okay, so sender and receiver, have common clock. Whereas in the case of asynchronous, they will have separate clocks because they are using their internal clocks. So for transmitter, there will be a separate internal clock, and for receiver also, it will have a separate internal clock. Next difference we have is that in the synchronous method, the blocks of data or frames are send it, means they are whenever transmission of data is taking place, then blocks of data or frames of data are transmitted. But in the case of asynchronous, only one bit is transmitted at a time. So here bit by bit the data is transmitted, whereas in synchronous blocks of data is transmitted. Next difference is that the synchronous method, it is having a very high speed of transmission, so it is used in cases where the speed required for the transmission is fast, means faster transmission we require. In that case we use synchronous method, whereas asynchronous, its speed of transmission is very slow. So here used for high speed transmission. Next difference is that in synchronous, because we are using separate signals, two signals are required. One is the clock signal and second is the data signal. So synchronous, it will require more circuits in that, more hardware is required. So we can say that synchronous method is expensive method, whereas asynchronous is this cheaper. Why it is expensive? Because it require hardware. What we can say, more hardware is required. Whereas in the case of asynchronous, less hardware is required. Next difference is, as we are talking that in synchronous method, the less hardware is required, and in asynchronous, more hardware is required, whereas in asynchronous, less hardware is required. Also, in synchronous, only hardware is required. No software part is required because we need only the clock signal and the data bits. Whereas in the asynchronous, we require both hardware and the software because we have to add the start and the stop bits also. We have to generate a parity bit. So in the case of asynchronous, software part is also required. So in synchronous, we can say only hardware is required. So for asynchronous, we require both hardware and software. Next difference is that in synchronous, because we require the clock pulses, synchronous pulses are required, whereas in asynchronous, no synchronous pulses are required because no clock pulses used in this method. So here we can say synchronous pulses. No synchronous pulses are required. It uses start and stop bits. Instead of that, synchronous pulses, here start and stop bits are required. Next difference is that in the synchronous, constant time interval should be there, because in synchronous we are transmitting blocks of data and frames of data, so there should be a constant time interval. The clock pulse is also a periodic pulse here. So here we can say that synchronous data transmission, it is used in applications when there is a constant time interval between the data. So here the time interval is constant. Whereas in asynchronous, as we are transmitting a single bit at a time, one bit at a time is transmitted. So it can be used in applications where the time interval is random or irregular. Now in synchronous, because blocks of data, frames of data is transmitted, so there is no gap between the data. Whereas in asynchronous, one bit at a time is transmitted, so there is a chance of a gap between the data. Because start and stop bits are there, again if the next byte is transmitted, then that byte will also have start and stop bits. So there is always a start and the stop bits between two blocks of data. Whereas in the synchronous, blocks of data are transmitted at the same time, means simultaneously they are transmitted, so there is no gap between the data. Whereas in asynchronous, gap is present. Now if we talk about the applications or the examples of synchronous and asynchronous method of communication, then for synchronous we can give the example of a chat room or video conferencing. All these are a types of synchronous data transmission, where blocks of data, because in chat room when a person is talking, they are in a group of people, they are talking to each other, so that is the kind of communication taking place, that is in a large number. Whereas in asynchronous, the examples can be letters, emails. These type of communications come under the asynchronous method, because in this, in letters we are writing the data, and means number of letters can be sent. There can be a time interval between it. Whereas in chat room and video conferencing, the data, means blocks of data, is transmitted between the people. Okay. So these are the types of examples of synchronous and asynchronous data transmission. So here we studied about the differences between the two methods, that the synchronous method, the major difference we talk about is that in synchronous data transmission, we have a clock pulse, and that clock pulse is synchronized for both the receiver and the transmitter. Both transmitter and receiver, they share one single clock, whereas in the case of asynchronous, no external clock is required. Transmitter and receiver, they are going to use their internal clock for all the operations, and no synchronization is there. That is why it is called asynchronous method. So we studied all the differences between the synchronous and asynchronous method. I hope that this topic is clear to you. Thank you.